Daily Evening Prayer, Thursday, September 19th, 2024. O worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Let the whole earth stand in awe of him. Let us humbly confess our sins to Almighty God. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from your ways, lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against your holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done, and we have done those things which we ought not to have done. And apart from your grace, there is no health in us. O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare all those who confess your faults. Restore all those who are penitent, according to your promises declared to all people in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may now live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Grant to your faithful people, merciful Lord, pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins. And serve you with a quiet mind through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be. World without end. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Lord's name be praised. O gladsome light, pure brightness of the ever-living Father in heaven, O Jesus Christ, holy and blessed, now as we come to the setting of the sun and our eyes behold the vesper light. We sing your praises, O God, Father, Son, O Holy Spirit. You are worthy at all times to be praised by happy voices. O Son of God, O Giver of life, and to be glorified through all the worlds. O sing unto the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous things. With his own right hand and with his holy arm, he has won for himself the victory. The Lord declared his salvation. His righteousness has he openly shown in the sight of the nations. He has remembered his mercy and truth toward the house of Israel, and all the ends of the world have seen the salvation of our God. Show yourselves joyful in the Lord, all you lads. Sing, rejoice, and give thanks. Praise the Lord with the harp. Sing with the harp a psalm of thanksgiving, with trumpets also and horns. Oh, show yourselves joyful before the Lord, the King. Let the sea make a noise and all that is in it, the round world and those who dwell therein. Let the rivers clap their hands and let the hills be joyful together before the Lord, for he has done, for he has come to judge the earth. With righteousness shall he judge the world and the peoples with equity. The Lord is King, let the peoples tremble. He sits between the cherubim, let the earth shake. The Lord is great in Zion, and high above all peoples. They shall give thanks unto his name, which is great and wonderful. Holy is he and mighty, a king who loves justice. He hath established equity, he hath executed judgment and righteousness in Jacob. O magnify the Lord our God, and fall down before his footstool, for he is holy. Moses and Aaron among his priests, and Samuel among those who call upon his name, they called unto him, and he heard them. He spoke to them out of the cloudy pillar, for they kept his testimonies and the law that he gave them. You heard them, O Lord our God. You forgave them, O Lord, yet punished their evil doings. O magnify the Lord our God and worship him upon his holy hill, for the Lord our God is holy. Oh, be joyful at the Lord, all you lads. Serve the Lord with gladness and come before his presence with a song. Be assured that the Lord, he is God, it is he that has made us and not we ourselves. We are his people, the sheep of his pasture. Oh, go your way to his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and speak it of his name. For the Lord is gracious, his mercy is everlasting, and his truth endures from generation to generation. My song shall be of mercy and judgment. Unto you, O Lord, will I sing. Oh, let me have understanding in the way of godliness. When will you come to me? I will walk in my house with integrity of heart. I will set no wicked thing before my eyes. I hate the sins of unfaithfulness. No such thing shall cleave to me. A crooked heart shall depart from me. I will not know a wicked person. Whoever secretly slanders his neighbor, him will I destroy. Whoever has a proud look and an arrogant heart, I will not suffer him. My eyes shall look with favor upon the faithful in the land, that they may dwell with me. Whoever leads a godly life, he shall be my servant. No deceitful person shall dwell in my house. The one who tells lies shall not tarry in my sight. I shall soon destroy all the ungodly who are in the land, that I may root out all evildoers from the city of the Lord. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the prophet Haggai, beginning with the first chapter, the first verse. In the second year of Darius the king, on the first day of the sixth month, the word of the Lord came by the prophet Haggai to Zerubbabel, the son of Shealtiel, governor of Judah, and to Joshua, the son of Jehozadak, the high priest, saying, "This is what the Lord of armies says. This people says, the time has not come. The time for the house of the Lord to be rebuilt." That the word of the Lord came by Haggai, the prophet, saying, "It is time for you yourselves to live in your paneled houses well. Is it time for you yourselves to live in your paneled houses while this house remains desolate? Now then, the Lord of armies says this, consider your ways. You have sown much only to harvest little. You eat, but there is not enough to be satisfied. You drink, but there is not enough to become drunk. You put on clothing, but there is not enough for anyone to get warm. And the one who earns wages to put into a money bag full of holes." The Lord of armies says this, consider your ways. Go up to the mountains, bring wood, and rebuild a temple that I may be pleased with it and be honored, says the Lord. You start an ambitious project, but behold, it comes to little. When you bring it home, I blow it away. Why, declares the Lord of armies, it is because of my house which remains desolate, while each of you runs to his own house. Therefore, because of you, the sun, the sky will has withheld its dew, and the earth has withheld its produce. And I called for a drought on the land, on the mountains, on the grain, on the new wine, on the oil, on what the ground produces, on mankind, on cattle, and on all the products of the labor of your hands. Then Zerubbabel the king, the son of Shealtiel, and Joshua the son of Jehozadak, the high priest, with all the remnant of the people, obeyed the voice of the Lord their God and the words of Haggai the prophet, just as the Lord their God had sent him. And the people showed reverence for the Lord. Then Haggai, the messenger of the Lord, spoke by the commission of the Lord to the people, saying, "I am with you, declares the Lord." So the Lord stirred up the spirit of Zerubbabel, the son of Shealtiel, governor of Judah, and the spirit of Joshua, the son of Jehozadak, the high priest, and the spirit of all the remnant of the people, and they came and worked at the house of the Lord of armies, their God, on the 24th day of the sixth month, in the second year of Darius the king. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has regarded the lowliness of his handmaiden. For behold, from now on all generations will call me blessed, for he that is mighty has magnified me, and holy is his name, and his mercy is on those who fear him throughout all generations. He has shown the strength of his arm, he has scattered the proud in the imagination of their hearts. He has brought down the mighty from their thrones, and has exalted the humble and meek. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent empty away. He, remembering his mercy, has helped his servant Israel, as he promised to our fathers, Abraham, and his seed forever. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to St. Matthew, beginning with the 14th chapter, the first verse. At that time, Herod the Tetrarch heard the news about Jesus and said to his servants, "This is John the Baptist. He himself has been raised from the dead, and that is why miraculous powers are at work in him. For when Herod had John arrested, he bound him and put him in prison because of Herodias, the wife of his brother Philip. For John had been saying to him, 'It is not lawful for you to have her.' Although Herod wanted to put him to death, he feared the crowd, because they regarded John as a prophet. But when Herod's birthday came, the daughter of Herodias danced before them and pleased Herod so much that he promised with an oath to give her whatever she asked. And after being prompted by her mother, she said, 'Give me the head of John the Baptist here on a platter.' And although he was grieved, the king commanded it to be given because of these oaths and his dinner guests. He sent word and had John beheaded in prison, and his head was brought on a platter and given to the girl, and she brought it to her mother. John's disciples came and took away the body and buried it, and they went and reported to Jesus. Then when Jesus heard about John, he withdrew from there in a boat to a secluded place by himself. And when the people heard about this, they followed him on foot from the cities. When he came ashore, he saw a large crowd and felt compassion for them and healed their sick. Now when it was evening, the disciples came to him and said, 'This place is secluded, and the hour is already past to eat. Send the crowds away so that they may go into the villages and buy food for themselves.' But Jesus said to them, 'They do not need to go. You give them something to eat.' They said to him, 'We have nothing here except 5 loaves and 2 fish. And he said, "Bring them here to me." And ordering the crowds to sit down on the grass, he took the 5 loaves and the 2 fish and looked up toward heaven. He blessed the food, and breaking the loaves, he gave them to the disciples, and the disciples gave them to the crowds. And they all ate and were satisfied. And they packed up what was left over of the broken pieces, 12 full baskets. There were about 5,000 men who ate, besides women and children. Immediately afterward, he compelled the disciples to get into the boat and to go ahead of him to the other side while he sent the crowds away. After he had sent the crowds away, he went up on the mountain by himself to pray, and when it was evening, he was there alone. But the boat was already a long distance from the land, battered by the waves, for the wind was contrary. And in the fourth watch of the night, he came to them, walking on the sea. When the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were terrified and said, "Is it a ghost?" And they cried out in fear. But immediately Jesus spoke to them, saying, "Take courage, it is I, do not be afraid." Peter responded and said to him, "Lord, if it is you, command me to come to you on the water." And he said, "Come." And Peter got out of the boat and walked on the water and came toward Jesus. But seeing the wind, he became frightened, and when he began to sink, he cried out, saying, "Lord, save me." Immediately Jesus reached out with his hand and took hold of him and said to him, "You of little faith, why do you doubt?" When they got into the boat, the wind stopped, and those who were in the boat worshipped him, saying, "You are truly God's son." When they had crossed over, they came to land at Gennesaret. And when the men of that place recognized him, they sent word into all that surrounding region and brought to him all who were sick. And they pleaded with him that they might just touch the border of his cloak, and all who touched it were cured. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Lord, now let your servant depart in peace according to your word, for my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared before the face of all people, to be a light to light to the Gentiles, and to be the glory of your people Israel. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was at the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. That this evening may be holy, good, and peaceful, we entreat you, Lord. That your holy angels may lead us in paths of peace and goodwill, we entreat you, Lord. That we may be pardoned and forgiven for our sins and offenses, we entreat you, Lord. That there may be peace in your church and in the whole world, we entreat you, Lord. That we may depart this life in your faith and fear, and not be condemned before the great judgment seat of Christ, we entreat you, Lord. O God, because without you we are not able to please you, mercifully grant that your Holy Spirit may in all things direct and rule our hearts through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, with God now and forever. Amen. Lord Jesus, stay with us, for evening is at hand and the day is past. Be our companion in the way, kindle our hearts and awaken hope, that we may know you as you are revealed in Scripture in the breaking of bread. Grant this for the sake of your love. Amen. O God, you manifest in your servants the signs of your presence, set forth upon us the spirit of love, that in companionship with one another, your abounding grace may increase among us through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for your immeasurable love in the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service, and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications to you, and you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will grant their requests. Fulfill now, Lord, our desires and petitions as we be blessed for us. Granting us at this one knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Be the God of hope, fill us with all joy and peace in believing through the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen.